connection of a DC motor. So this is the this is the construction of DC motor. So these parts you can see. So we you have a slot. Slot is inside. You have any motor will have a stator and a rotor. Stator is going to be the stationary portion, and the rotor is going to be the rotating portion. Okay, stator means it is going to be static. Static means it is not going to move, and rotor is going to move. Okay, it is going to the rotor is going to rotate. So you have the central most circular thing you see. We are seeing. I think this is going to be a side view. Okay. So side view, we are seeing the construction of a motor, and this central most portion is called as the this outermost cylinder. The outermost circular cylinder is going to be called as the yoke. So inside the yoke only, it is see here it is marked. This cylinder is called as yoke, and inside the yoke only you are going to keep your motor. And what is the purpose of this yoke? It is going to support the frame for the machine. It is going to provide the path for magnetic flux, and it is made up of cast iron or cast steel or forged steel. This should be very strong enough to withstand the motor in any tough condition. Okay, that is the functionality of coal. Usually small machines have cast iron yokes, and big or large machines will have cast steel or forged steel yoke. So yoke means it is the outermost cylinder, which will have, just like in a transformer, you have the container which is going to hold the entire transformer, right? So same way, the DC motor is held by a large cylinder called as yoke. So this cylinder will serve two purposes. One is it provides support, and it provides the path for magnetic flux. You see here, below the cylinder, you have the magnetic lines of force marked here. Okay, the magnetic lines of force are marked here. Okay, next part is poles. See where is the pole. This portion is called as a pole. Okay, this combination of this portion is called as a pole. Okay, see here, it is a salient pole. They are fixed on the inner side of the yoke through bolts. So yoke is the outermost cylinder, and inside the yoke you fix the poles using bolt. These poles are fixed to the yoke using bolt. Here, how many poles I have? In the diagram which you see, how many poles I have?
Four.
You have four poles. And four poles are fixed to the yoke using bolt. They are not permanently welded. They are fixed using bolt, and you can remove the bolt, and you can remove the poles in case they are defective. Okay. The cross section of the pole core is rectangular. See here, if you see the cross section, it will look like a rectangle. Approximately a rectangle, it will look like a rectangle. Okay, the cross section is rectangular. By attaching a pole shoe, the end of the pole is made to have a cylindrical surface. By attaching a pole shoe, this is your pole shoe. It will look like the end is going to be a cylindrical surface. It is actually a rectangle. By attaching a pole shoe, I make the end look like a cylinder. Okay, so the pole, four poles are going to be rectangular in cross section. The ends are going to be attached using the pole shoes and made circular, so that when they rotate, it will look like, when you see from the side, it will form a circle. Okay, and also, you know, circle means the friction will be less, and rectangle means it will not be perfectly fit into the circular yoke. Everything is circle here, and rectangle is an odd man out here, right? So if I want to convert this rectangle into circular, I am doing it. I am attaching a pole shoe and making the circumference of pole shoe to be circular, so that while rotating, it's not going to have any issues. The cross-section area of the pole shoe is larger than that of the pole core to leave as little space as possible. So there is very much little space between the cross-section area and the pole shoe. So this is done to prevent your leakage flux. What they say is, immediately after your cross-section, rectangular pole core, you will be having the pole shoe. This is done to ensure minimum leakage flux. So to avoid leakage flux, this arrangement is done. And they are made of cast steel or forged steel, as like your yoke. And each pole carries a field coil or exciting coil. Small machines generally use permanent magnet. So generally, I want to create magnetic effect. So either I can use coils to, I will pass current through the coil and create magnetic effect, or small machines will have direct magnets inside. You see here, inside the pole, you have windings. And because of windings, you will have, when current is going to flow through the winding, you will have magnetic flux. Okay, if you don't want to create magnetic flux through the coils, you can use permanent magnets to produce the same effect. Okay, so I will repeat, the outermost cylinder of your machine is called as yoke. It is made up of steel or iron, and it is going to support your machine, and it is going to provide the paths for magnetic flux. Inside the yoke, you will have poles, and poles are bolted to the circumference of your yoke. Poles have two components. One is core and shoe. Core is rectangular. Shoe is the end of shoe is circular, and between the core and shoe, the gap is very, very minimum to prevent leakage flux. And poles carry field coil or exciting coil. They are called so because they produce magnetic field. If you don't want to have a coil inside the pole, directly you can use permanent magnets. Okay, and the field coils, they are wound on the pole cores and are supported by the pole shoes. All the coils are identical, connected in series, such that an excitation by DC is alternate N and S poles are made. A machine always has even number of poles. See here, I have told you here we have four poles. It is an even number. It is ensured that if one pole is north pole, other pole will be south pole. The current, if you change the direction of flow of current, naturally the pole will be different, right? So that is the key. So when the current is entering the pole, assume this. When the current is entering the pole, assume this one is south pole. And here, when the current is leaving the pole, it is going to be north pole. Okay, always we'll see with the shoes. So if the current is leaving the shoe, it is north pole. If the current is entering the shoe, it is going to be south pole. So just by proper arrangement of all these windings, I'll ensure that alternatively the poles are going to have alternate north pole and south pole, just because of placing the winding and passing the appropriate current. And also the number of poles are going to be always even in number. So the machine will have even number of poles. By passing the appropriate current and using an appropriate series connection, alternate north and south poles are created. Okay. So you see here, this is the magnetic flux distribution for a four pole machine. For one half cycle, you see that pole is north pole. For second half cycle, that pole is going to be south pole. So it is going to alternate between north pole and south pole. And remember, this is a DC machine. AC la automatica frequency ingra term vandrum, but DC la there is frequency is going to be zero, correct? How am I going to change the polarity of a pole in a DC machine? See, AC, if you give AC current, automatically for one half cycle it will be north pole, for other half cycle automatically it will be south pole, correct? But in a DC machine, the frequency is zero. I am not going to use any AC supply, so I am going to use only DC supply. With that, how am I able to achieve alternating north pole and south pole? Can anybody say the answer for that? See, in AC, the signal variation is there. So automatically you will get north and south. But in DC, the signal variation is constant. So, either which NR north pole, south pole, I cannot arrive at. But what one thing I have in direct current is, by changing the direction of flow of the current, I can easily make it as north pole or south pole. Okay. If the current is coming inwards, if it is going to be north pole, then the current is going to leave, it's going to be south pole. So indirectly, by changing the direction of current, I can easily change the poles from north pole to south pole and south pole to north pole. So we are going to stop here in DC motor. Any doubts so far, you can ask.
Sir, can you explain that four pole DC machine one more time, sir?